Hello students, today I will talk about law of conservation of mass. First of all, you should know what is the definition of conservation of mass. It states that mass can neither be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction or during any change. Matter is neither created nor destroyed, however it may change from one form to another. This is only known as law of conservation of mass. Is this clear? That total mass of reactant will be equal to total mass of product always. This law was given by Lavoisier. For example, we'll take one example here. I have written one equation, chemical equation. You all can see calcium carbonate, when heated it will decompose to give calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Now we will calculate the mass of calcium carbonate used and mass of calcium oxide and carbon dioxide produced. I hope you can calculate molecular mass. How to calculate molecular mass? Add atomic mass of each atom present in one molecule. Okay, here calcium, atomic mass of calcium is 40. 40 plus 12 plus 16 multiplied by 3. Why? Because oxygen, 3 atoms are present. We'll get 100 gram. It means when 100 gram of calcium carbonate is heated, it will form 56 gram of calcium oxide and 44 gram of carbon dioxide will be evolved. If we add 56 plus 44, what will get? 100 gram. It verifies law of conservation of mass, that mass of the reactant is equal to mass of the product. Is it clear? To verify, we'll take one experiment. We'll take Landolt's tube, special tube which have two limbs. In one limb we can take solution of sodium chloride, in another limb we will take solution of silver nitrate. Okay, we will seal the tube and then take the weight of the Landolt's tube. We will note down somewhere. Now invert the tube so that solutions can mix up together and react chemically. Okay, first we will take the solution in different limbs. In one limb what we had taken, sodium chloride solution, and in second limb we will take silver nitrate solution. Seal the tube and take the weight of the tube and note down somewhere. Now we will invert the tube so that solution mix together to form new product. NaCl, sodium chloride solution, react with silver nitrate to form white precipitate of silver chloride plus sodium nitrate. Again we will take the weight of the tube. We will see the mass of the tube is found to be exactly same. There is no change in the mass of the tube. It verifies law of conservation of mass. Another example also we can take, in place of sodium chloride we can take barium chloride, solution of barium chloride. We can mix it with sodium sulfate. Okay, before mixing we can take the weight and then mix the solution. Reaction will take place to form barium sulfate and sodium chloride. After reaction, again if we take the weight, again what we will see, the mass of the tube is found to be exactly same.